Okay, I wanted to answer the question, why do fixed costs in total stay the same, which is what we're used to hearing. Fixed costs stay the same as production increases. But when we're asked what happens per unit for fixed costs, they actually go down. So here's why. If we think about a perfume manufacturer, so they're going to manufacture perfume, one of the variable costs would be the perfume bottle. We're going to say it costs a dollar per bottle. One of the fixed costs would be the plant manager's salary. He is going to be paid $40,000 a year. So let's look and see what happens. For the variable cost of the glass bottle, which is a dollar per bottle, if we produce one bottle, the price per bottle is a dollar. If we produce 10 bottles, the price per bottle is still a dollar. And if we produce 100, it is still a dollar. But let's look at the plant manager's salary. If the plant manufactures one bottle, we would say that his salary per bottle is $40,000. If they produce 10 bottles, we would say that his salary, $40,000 per unit, 10 units, so divide by 10, would be $4,000. And if they produce 100 bottles, we would say that his salary, $40,000 per, which means divide, bottle, there's 100 bottles, would be $400. So the more we produce, the less per unit his salary is. So let's look at the total cost, which is how we normally think about it. So variable costs for a dollar, if you produce one, would be one. If you produce 10 bottles, then you've got one times 10, which is 10, $10. And if you produce 100 bottles, then you have one times 100, or 100. But the plant salary total cost is $40,000. If you produce one, it's $40,000. If you produce 10, it's still $40,000 in total. And if you produce 100, it's still $40,000. So in total, fixed costs stay the same, but per unit they go down. It is the opposite for variable costs. In total, variable costs go up, but per unit, they stay the same. So let me know if you have any questions. Thanks.